Hey guys, so today I'm gonna have a little story for you guys. It's about a project that we used to do a few months ago, and yeah, so I'm gonna take you to Lai. Here he is.
Hi.
So he's gonna explain a bit about what the project we're doing.
Initially, I received the email when I'm overseas,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
it is a really really challenging project because we never do mural before.
Mm-hmm.
So we buy a few paint,
mm-hmm.
we go to our friend's office,
mm-hmm.
and started doing our personal mural,
mm-hmm.
just for fun, mm-hmm. and then it's for their office as well.
Mm-hmm.
We try to look at how well the paint sticks, what kind of paint is suitable, mm-hmm. how long we take to paint. This area and how many layers, that kind of stuff. We experiment, and while doing that, we also proceed in working on the visual. So I'm trying to simplify all the buildings into a way that no one ever see before. Okay, this is a very interesting project. So client doesn't control our creative freedom at all. So this is the only project that I reject my own design, I think many times, just to get the exact feeling that I want. It's a really interesting one because everyone has different color sense. We just let CS do the color only. I think biggest challenge is it's not the painting part actually. Painting part is quite easy. I think it's the design, as I said earlier lah. Those things, those iterations. I think during the production, the most challenging should be the stairs. The stairs, because there are no way for us to stand the stairs properly. Uh-huh. I think. And then when I'm away for other projects, mm-hmm. and then you girls are having hard time to move around the stairs,
mm-hmm.
as I recall, that is the most challenging. Maybe you should ask CS.
Yeah.
Most challenging, but let's surprise her. Let's go. Most challenging part of the mural. Talking about the stairs.
I think the most challenging part is reaching like the top thing because it's really deep.
So the stair is wobbly.
Yeah.
And dangerous.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we are actually risking our life.
Yeah.
Doing the mural.
They really are.
And the stairs is really interesting where we can turn it into many shapes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Maybe you can show a picture of it.
Yeah.
Now. and then what else?
Mixing the color is really hard.
I think we messed up one part of the white color.
Uh-huh.
It's actually not white, it should be a light blue.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of color mixing error.
I have to mix it a different batch so it turns out slightly different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How many colors did you guys use in total? Like all the paints that you guys use?
A lot.
Mm-hmm.
Red, white, and a lot of white.
Mm-hmm.
Surprisingly reduced. A lot of white. I think at least 20 bottles of white.
Oh my god!
I think we emptied the stock right after the restock.
Yeah.
The empty restock.
Let's go and ask Beatrice.
I think we have to pre-plan a lot of things. It is more work. If you don't do the work before the mural, you take more time to finish the mural. You haven't planned it earlier on. The work will extend itself later in the project. We need a good team, and art director, for example. Without one vision, we cannot have one big art masterpiece by few different artists.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what I learned.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks, Beatrice.
Thank you.
Dania is the only one that can do. It's the only one that can do the tiny.
It's so fair.
Hello.
Create the tiny stroke that you did.
Without masking tape?
Yeah.
Because like after a while it just gets your head a bit having to draw like curved lines like for like a good 5 hours.
Yeah.
But you know, like it's just more about position and like using the right brush. Right brush is very important.
Mm-hmm.
We learned over time. Learned a lot of things like on the way. Put the ladder like on the walls.
Okay.
Like we should have put like a wall shirt around like the edges so you don't scratch the walls.
We should learn that earlier.
We learned it throughout because we ended up scratching the walls and then I was like, oh my god, yeah, we should have done that.
There's something that you also say like, oh, for mixing colors. What do you learn? Like,
mixing
formula?
One person has to do it and yeah, there should be a ratio. Because basically like we would miss a tint. and then we'll be like, oh man, we gotta repaint the whole thing again. Like, so it's just small things like that, I suppose. But it was good progress, I guess.
The biggest takeaway for me is the team have a chance to bond each other. I think that is my biggest takeaway. It's not the money, not really the portfolio.
Yeah, exactly.
That's actually my biggest takeaway. So that ends the vlog today.